Then let's start. You can type your attendance now. Okay. Okay. What about your homework? Is subtraction is associative for rational numbers? No. Everybody, is it yes or no?
No.
No. Okay. Then we got subtraction is not associative for rational numbers. Then what is about multiplication? Let's check. Okay. For that, you can see in your textbook page number 8, there is a problem given. That is minus 7 by 3 into minus, sorry, 5 by 4 into, I just type here. The question is minus 7 by 3 into 5 by 4 into 2 by 9. Clear? I am going to separate this by a bracket here. Okay. Then, while multiplying rational numbers, what do we have to do? We have to multiply the corresponding denominators and the corresponding numerators, right? Yes. Then, first I am writing minus 7 by 3 as itself. What happened inside the bracket? Inside our bracket, there is 5 by 9 into 2 by 9. What is the product of 5 by 9 into 2 by 9? Here, numerators are 5 and 2. Then the corresponding numerator is 5 into 2, which is 10. And the corresponding denominator is, here we have denominators as 4 and 9, then their product 36, right? 36 is being the denominator for the product. Now we have to calculate the remaining product. That is, here, now here the numerators are minus 7 and 10, and the denominators are 3 and 36. Clear? Yes. Now, what is the product of numerators? It is minus 7 into 10. That is minus 70. Clear? Yes. Then, what about numerator? The numerator is 3 into 36, which is 108. Clear? You can see this in your textbook, page number 8. Did you see in it? Yes. Then how we can simplify this? We can divide both 70 and 108 by 2. Is it? Yes. Then what is the half of 70? Half of 70 is 35.
Five.
Okay. Then half of minus 70 is minus 35. Is it? Yes. Then half of 108 is this 54.
54.
Yes, it is 54. So our product become minus 35 by 54. Now, this is our LHS. I am considering this is as our LHS. Okay. Then I'm just rearranging our bracket as we have done in our earlier. So I'm putting bracket here for minus 7 by 3 into 5 by 4. Okay. then it multiplies by 2 by 9. Then what was the sum now? Here inside the bracket there are minus 7 by 3 and 5 by 4. Okay, their product is, numerator is the product of minus 7 and 5. What is the product of minus 7 and 5? This minus 35, right? Don't write this. You can just see this because this is already given in your textbook. Okay. Page number 8. Now, we get the numerator as minus 35. Then we have to find the denominator. Here we have the denominators as 3 and 4, right? Then their product, that is 3 into 4, which is 12. That is our denominator. Clear? Okay. Then there is a 2 by 9 remaining. So we have to find the product of minus 35 by 12 into 2 by 9. Here is also, we have to find the product as, what is the product of minus 35 into 2? It is minus 70, right? Minus 70. And what about the denominator? Denominator is the product of 12 and 9. What is the product of 12 and 9? It is again 108. Clear? Yes. Then we can simplify as we have done earlier. Minus 70 by 2, which is minus 35. And then it is 54. Here we get, what we get here? Both, this is RHS, right? Here both the LHS and RHS are equal. Is it? Yes. So we can say rational numbers are associative under multiplication. Clear? Yes. First we have to say rational numbers are associative for addition, and then it is not associative for subtraction. Now it is associative for multiplication. Clear? Then what about division? Let's check. We have to check. For that I am taking three rational numbers. They are 1 by 2, they are 1 by 2, minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3, and 2 by 5. To check the associativity of rational numbers under division, we have chosen three rational numbers, right? Yes, they are 1 by 2, minus 1 by 3, and 2 by 3. For checking that, I am just writing 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Here, I am using the symbol slash for indicating the division. Okay, are you all fine? Okay, then 1 by 2 divided by minus 1 by 3. I think this representation is little bit strange, right? Here, this slash symbol indicates division. You can just see in your textbook. Look at your textbook. Did you see it? Okay, I'm here representing this slash line for representing the division, okay? And then I am also, here also I am giving a slash line for indicate division of 2 by 5. Okay. Now, first we have to find the division of 1 by 2 divided by minus 1 by 3. For finding the answer. How we can do the division of rational numbers? For dividing a rational number by another rational number, we have to take what? Reciprocal, right? We have to take reciprocal of the second number and then multiply it with the first number. Okay. So I am writing 1 by 2 here. 1 by 2 itself, and then division changed to multiplication, that is multiplied by reciprocal of minus 1 by 3 is what? And Anne Maria, what is the reciprocal of minus 1 by 3? Please unmute and say. Okay, that's fine. The reciprocal is changing denominators as numerator and numerator as denominator. Here we have the rational number minus 1 by 3. So its reciprocal is 3 by 1.
3 by 1.
Or it is minus 3 by 1. 3 by 1 can be represented as 3 itself. So we can represent this minus 3 by 1 as minus 3 itself. Okay. Here our operation change to minus 1 by 2 is multiplied by minus 3. And here is a division of 2 by 5. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Then what is the product of 1 by 2 and minus 3? The product is minus 3 is multiplied by this denominator 1 and 2 is the denominator. So 1 into minus 3 is minus 3 itself divided by 2. It is minus 3 by 2. And we have to divide it by 2 by 5. Here is again we have to take the reciprocal of 2 by 5. Now what is the reciprocal of minus 2 by 5? What is the reciprocal? It is Dia. What is the reciprocal of 2 by 5? Okay, Alan. Please unmute and say. What is the reciprocal? Just change denominator as numerator and numerator as denominator. Just interchange them. Parnyo. Okay, that's fine. Here, numerator is 2 and denominator is 5. By interchanging these two, we get it is 5 by 2, right?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have any doubt in writing the reciprocal? Anybody? No. No. Okay. Then, now the product is the answer. Here the denominators are endo parnjo
2.
Okay, denominator is 2 and the numerators are minus 3 and 5, right? Then the product of numerator is the product of minus 3 and 5.
And 5,
it is minus
3, 15.
Very good. It is minus 15 and the denominator is the product of 2 with 2. That is 4. Now we get the division. That is 1 by 2 divided by minus 1 by 3. Again divided by 2 by 5 as minus 15 by 4. Is it? Okay. Then I'm going to interchange the bracket as we have done in earlier. Yes. Parnyo.
Miss avasana answer namaku kittunnille. Ainde avade aa minus 15 engane vannu.
Minus 15 vanna ennu vachale nammada first rational number eda minus 3 by 2 and the second rational number is 5 by 2. നമുക്ക് രണ്ട് റാഷൻ നമ്പറിന്റെ പ്രൊഡക്റ്റ് എങ്ങനെയാണ് കണ്ടെത്തുന്നത്? ന്യൂമറേറ്റർ ഈസ് മൾട്ടിപ്ലൈഡ് ബൈ ന്യൂമറേറ്റർ ആൻഡ് ഡിനോമിനേറ്റർ ഈസ് മൾട്ടിപ്ലൈഡ് ബൈ ഡിനോമിനേറ്റർ. ഫസ്റ്റ് റാഷൻ നമ്പറിൽ ന്യൂമറേറ്റർ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് മൈനസ് ത്രീ ആണ്. സെക്കൻഡ് റാഷൻ നമ്പറിൽ ന്യൂമറേറ്റർ ഫൈവും ആണ്. അപ്പോൾ ന്യൂമറേറ്റേഴ്സിന്റെ പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് അതായത് മൈനസ് ത്രീ ഇൻറ്റു ഫൈവ് അതാണ് മൈനസ് ഫിഫ്റ്റീൻ നമ്മുടെ ന്യൂമറേറ്റർ വന്നത്. ക്ലിയർ?
മിസ്,
യെസ്
മിസ്, ഫൈവിന്റെ അവിടെ പ്ലസ് അല്ല, അപ്പൊ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ സംഖ്യയുടെ അല്ലേ ആൻസറിന്റെ അവിടെ എഴുതാൻ പറ്റുള്ളൂ?
അത് നമ്മൾ അഡീഷണൽ അല്ലേ മോനെ, ഇതിവിടെ മൾട്ടിപ്ലിക്കേഷൻ അല്ലേ, അഡീഷനിലാണ് നമ്മൾ ഏതാ ലാർജസ്റ്റ് നമ്പറിന്റെ സൈൻ സമ്മിന് കൊടുക്കുന്നത്. മൾട്ടിപ്ലിക്കേഷനിൽ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു ഡിജിറ്റ് നെഗറ്റീവ് ആണെങ്കിൽ നമ്മുടെ റിസൾട്ട് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നെഗറ്റീവ് ആയിരിക്കും അല്ലേ. അതെ. അപ്പോ അത് സെവൻത്തിൽ നിങ്ങൾ പഠിച്ചതല്ലേ, ഓർക്കുന്നുണ്ടോ? അത് രണ്ട് ഒരു നെഗറ്റീവ് നമ്പറും ഒരു പോസിറ്റീവ് നമ്പറും മൾട്ടിപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ റിസൾട്ട് നെഗറ്റീവ്. രണ്ട് നെഗറ്റീവ് നമ്പർ ആണ് മൾട്ടിപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്നെങ്കിൽ റിസൾട്ട് പോസിറ്റീവ്. അതുപോലെ ഓൾഡ് നമ്പർ ഓഫ് നെഗറ്റീവ് നമ്പേഴ്സ് ആണ് നമ്മൾ മൾട്ടിപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്നെങ്കിൽ അതിന്റെ റിസൾട്ട് നെഗറ്റീവ് ആയിരിക്കും. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഈവൺ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് നെഗറ്റീവ് നമ്പേഴ്സ് ആണ് മൾട്ടിപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്നെങ്കിൽ അതിന്റെ റിസൾട്ട് പോസിറ്റീവ് ആയിരിക്കും. ഇത് നമ്മൾ സെവൻത്തിൽ പഠിച്ചതാ കേട്ടോ. അത് വെച്ചാണ് ഇവിടെ മൈനസ് ഫിഫ്റ്റീൻ വന്നത്. ക്ലിയർ അല്ലേ? ഓക്കെ. നൗ ഐ ആം ഗോയിങ് ടു ചേഞ്ച് ദ പൊസിഷൻ ഓഫ് അവർ ബ്രാക്കറ്റ്. ഫോർ ദാറ്റ് ഐ ആം റൈറ്റിംഗ് 1/2 ഡിവൈഡഡ് ബൈ, ഐ എം പുട്ടിംഗ് ബ്രാക്കറ്റ് ഹിയർ, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് മൈനസ് 1/3 ഡിവൈഡഡ് ബൈ 2/5. Here we have to find the answer as, first we have to find the answer inside our bracket. For that I am writing 1/2 itself and divided by inside our bracket. We have to multiply with reciprocal, right? Yes, here minus 1/3 is written as itself. Then what is the reciprocal of 2/5? It is 5/2. It is 5/2. Then the product of minus 1/3 and 5/2 is, what is it product? 1/2 divided by the product as numerator is minus 1 and 5. So their product is minus 5 itself and denominator is 3 and 2. Then their product is 6. 3 × 2 = 6. Then their answer is minus 5/6. Here also we have to do the division of two rational numbers. For that we have again taking the reciprocal of minus 5/6, which is minus 6/5. Clear? Then their product become, here numerators are 1 and -6. Then what is this product? -6 × 1 = -6 itself. And the denominator is 2 and 5. Then the product of 2 and 5 = 10. So we get the answer as -6/10. Look here. Our first answer was -15/4 and now we get the answer as -6/10. Is it equal? No. So what we can say? Rational numbers are not associative under division. Clear? Any doubt? No. Okay. Alan, do you have any doubt? No, okay, that's fine. Then you have a table again given in your textbook of page number 9. Did you see it? Try this. Here also we have to fill the blanks. Okay. This is also I am given for you as your homework. I have already given a table in page number 6 for you. try these, and now I am giving try these question in page number 9 also. Okay. After that, we can see that there are two examples with solution for finding sum of rational numbers and the multiplication of rational numbers. Okay. You just look at them, and if you have any doubt, then ask me. Okay. After the class. Because the solution is already given there. I think you just have to look them. You know how to find the LCM? Yes. Anybody have any doubt in finding LCMs? Ijaz, do you have any doubt? Yes. Anne Maria, what about you? Do you know how to find LCM? Okay. Alan, what about you? Yes. Diya, Faith and Sridev.
Missy, anything pagdiin clear alla.
Clear alla. Okay. Mon LCM kandatha nariyona chodichathu. LCM.
Anga miss?
LCM.
Pandudikan ariyo miss.
Miss, clear kettilla miss, clear aayilla.
LCM. LCM ile LCM.
Ariya miss,
ariya. What about Diya? Diya is connecting to audio. Okay, that's fine. അറിയാത്തവർക്ക് മിസ് പറഞ്ഞു തരാം. ഒരു ഇപ്പോ നമ്മുടെ എക്സാമ്പിൾ വണ്ണില് 7, 11, 21 and 22 ഈ നാല് ഡിജിറ്റ്സിന്റെ എൽ സി എം 462 ആണെന്ന് തന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. അതെങ്ങനെയാണ് കണ്ടെത്തുന്നത് ടീച്ചർ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നോട്ടിൽ തരാം. അപ്പൊ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒരു കണക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നത് എങ്ങനെയാന്ന് ക്ലിയർ ആയി കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ പിന്നെ എൽ സി എം കണ്ടെത്തുന്നത് ക്ലിയർ ആവും. ഓക്കെ അല്ലേ? ഇതിന്റെ നോട്ട് ഞാൻ തരാം, എൽ സി എം എങ്ങനെയാണ് കണ്ടെത്തുന്നത്. അത് നോക്കുക, എന്നിട്ട് വേറെ നമ്പർ എടുത്ത് ചെയ്ത് നോക്കുക. എന്നിട്ട് ക്ലിയർ ആകുന്നില്ല എങ്കിൽ എന്നോട് ചോദിക്കാം, ഞാൻ പേഴ്സണൽ ആയിട്ട് പറഞ്ഞുതരാം. ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ, ദാറ്റ്സ് ഫൈൻ. ദെൻ നൗ വി ഹാവ് ടു മൂവ് അവർ നെക്സ്റ്റ് പ്രോപ്പർട്ടി. വാട്ട്സ് അവർ നെക്സ്റ്റ് പ്രോപ്പർട്ടി? അവർ നെക്സ്റ്റ് പ്രോപ്പർട്ടി ഈസ് ഗിവൺ ഇൻ അവർ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക് പേജ് നമ്പർ 10, വിച്ച് ഈസ് ദ റോൾ ഓഫ് സീറോ. The role of zero, or we can say it as the additive identity of rational number. The another name of role of zero is additive identity of rational numbers. Clear? Okay. Then what is an additive identity? We have studied about the additive identity of whole numbers, integers, and so on. What is the additive identity? In most of case, zero is being the additive identity. Why zero being the additive identity? Anybody remember? Shreya, do you remember? No. Okay, that's fine. Zero is the additive identity of whole number because when we add any whole number with zero, we get the same number itself. Okay, as in the same case of natural numbers or integers, when we add any number with zero, we get the same number. That's why zero is known as the additive identity. Got it? Yes. Then, is zero is the additive identity of rational number? Let's check. For that, I am choosing a rational number 2 by 3. When I am adding 2 by 3 with 0, what would be the answer? The answer is, please unmute and say. What's the answer?
2 by 3.
Okay, it is 2 by 3 itself. Very good. So, here also, when we are adding 0 with any rational number, we get the rational number itself. For that, I am choosing a by b as our rational number. I am adding a by b with zero, then I will get the answer as a by b itself. Clear? So we can say that zero is the additive identity of any rational number. So the what is the role of zero? If we add zero with any rational number, then we get the first rational number itself. So zero is known as the additive identity for rational number. Clear? Okay. Then similarly, what is the role of one? Here I am choosing the same rational number as 2/3. When I multiply these with 1, what happens? What is the answer? It is
2/3 itself.
Yes, it is 2/3 itself. Very good. That is, when we multiply any rational number with 1, we get the same rational number itself. So we can say that 1 is the multiplicative identity for rational number. 0 is the additive identity and 1 is the multiplicative identity. Okay. Clear? 0 is known as the additive identity because when we add 0 with any rational number, we get the same rational number. And 1 is known as the multiplicative identity of rational number. That's because when we multiply 1 with any rational number, we get the same rational number itself. Okay. Okay. Then it is our fifth property, that is role of 1 or multiplicative identity. Are you all clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Then there is a question to think, discuss and write, which is, if a property holds for rational numbers, will it also hold for integers, for whole numbers, which will not? Adayathu ipo nammal kore property padichallo, edokka padichu, closure property padichu, commutativity, associativity, role of 1, role of 0, ingane kore property padichu rational numbers inde case le. ഇത്തരത്തിലെ റാഷണൽ നമ്പേഴ്സിന് ഒരു പ്രോപ്പർട്ടി ഹോൾഡ് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അത് ഇൻറ്റീജേഴ്സിനും ഹോൾ നമ്പേഴ്സിനും ഹോൾഡ് ചെയ്യുമോ? ഏതൊക്കെ ചെയ്യും, ഏതൊക്കെ ചെയ്യില്ല? അതാണ് നമ്മുടെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. അത് നിങ്ങൾ ഹോംവർക്ക് ആയിട്ട് ചെയ്യണം. ഓക്കെ, മാർക്ക് ഇറ്റ് ആസ് യുവർ ഹോംവർക്ക്. തിങ്ക്, ഡിസ്കസ് ആൻഡ് റൈറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ Okay, that's fine. Next, our 1.206 is negative of a number. Our next property is negative of a number. Do you heard about negative of a number? Anybody? No. Don't worry. We have to check how to find a negative of any number. Here, we are starting with negative of a whole number. If this negative is also known as additive inverse. Okay. This negative of a number is also known as additive inverse. As in case of whole numbers, I am choosing 1 as a number, and when adding minus 1 to this 1, what will be the answer? The answer would be 0, right? Yes. Then this minus 1 is known as additive inverse of 1. Clear? Also, I can write the same as minus 1 plus 1, it's equal to 0. Then what is the additive inverse of minus 1? It is? Shreya, please unmute and say.
1.
Yes, it is 1 itself. So we can say that additive inverse of a number is which makes the sum 0. Okay. Then for a number A, what would be the additive inverse of A? The sum A and minus A makes 0. So we can say that the additive inverse of A is minus A. Also, the additive inverse of minus A is A for any number. Clear? Okay. Then in case of rational number, we have to check it. What is the additive inverse of a rational number? For that, I am choosing a rational number 2 by 3. Okay. Then I have to make this 2 by 3 by adding a number to be 0. Which number I have to add here for making this 2 by 3 and making this sum as 0? It is Shreya. Please unmute and say. For making this sum 0, we have to add a number. Here, first number I have chosen is 2 by 3. Then, e 2 by 3 odu ed number add edal aayirikum sum 0 avva.
Minus 2 by 3.
Yeah, very good. That is minus 2 by 3. Appo 2 by 3 inde kude nammal minus 2 by 3 add cheyumbulana namukku endu kittunnathu sum 0 aagunnathu. Then we can say 2 by 3 and then we can say minus 2 by 3 is the additive inverse of which number? 2 by 3. Okay. Similarly, 2 by 3 can be stated as the additive inverse of minus 2 by 3 itself. Okay. Then I am taking A by B as a rational number. Then what is the additive inverse of A by B?
Minus A by B.
Yes, it is minus A by B. Very good. So the sum of A by B and minus A by B is 0. That's why we can say that A by B is the additive inverse of minus A by B and minus A by B is the additive inverse of A by B. Clear? This additive inverse is also known as negative of a number. You can see here, we have just put a negative sign with our first rational number. Right?
Yes. Yes.
So, we can say this as a negative of a number or additive inverse of a number. In case of rational number, we have saying negative of a rational number or additive inverse of a rational number. Clear? Okay. Then, here is also, you have to find the additive inverse of a number which is minus 8 by 9. What is the additive inverse of minus 8 by 9? Which is given in your textbook, page number 12. What is it? Which is 8 by 9 itself, right? Okay. Then we are moving to our next property, which is reciprocal. What is reciprocal? We have discussed it many times while doing the division of rational numbers, right? Okay. So the reciprocal of rational number for a rational number A by B, the reciprocal should be, what is the reciprocal?
B by A.
Then here is a property, that is additive inverse. Sorry, multiplicative inverse. That is, when we multiply this A by B with the B by A, that is its reciprocal, we get the product as 1 itself. Okay. That is, when we multiply a number with its reciprocal, we get the answer as 1 always. Okay. Do you have any doubt? No. Dia. Okay, I think she's not here. Then this is known as the role of one or reciprocal or multiplicative inverse. Clear? So today we have discussed about what properties? Commutativity, role of zero, role of one, negative, reciprocal. Okay. Are you all clear? Okay. Then you should do your homework and send it to me. Okay. Then you can leave now.
Thank you, miss.
Okay.
Thank you, miss.